5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thunderbirds are go. Thunderbirds are go! I'm telling you, Brains, in no uncertain terms, that we now need a Thunderbird 6.
Sure, Mr. Tracy, but can you give me some sort of a steer? I like to work to a specification.
Specification? You didn't need to work to a specification when you designed that airship for the New World Aircraft Corporation.
That's right. I didn't. And what happened? They laughed.
Yeah, that's right. They laughed. And then they built it.
There you are, Brains. Your specially commissioned painting of Skyship One.
Thanks, Virgil. It's really great. But I guess that's about the nearest I'm gonna get to it for some time.
I'm sorry about this, Brains, but I've got this feeling, and I know I'm not wrong. We desperately need a Thunderbird 6.
That's okay, Mr. Tracy. Of course, I would have liked to have been on the maiden voyage.
Sure. But at least International Rescue will be represented by Alan, Tintin, and Penelope.
Well, I guess we've seen a lot of launchings, but this will beat all. Here she comes.
I think it's very elegant, m'lady. Mind you, I prefer miniskirts myself. But I suppose it's appropriate that you should be dressed like that for the revival of the airship, so to speak.
That's him, Parker. We must go onto the roof and see him land. Come on.
There it is, Tintin.
Yes, Alan. It looks lovely.
Okay, you know what to do.
Blimey! He's coming straight for us! I don't believe it.
Hi, Penny. Hi, Parker.
Excuse me?
All the family send their love to you.
Excuse me, Mr. Allen. Excuse me.
What is it, Parker?
Your aircraft, sir. It's got no pilot. I just thought I'd
put it out to you, sir.
Oh, forget about it, Parker. I finished with it now. Now, you were saying, Penelope.
Mr. Allen, please, don't you understand? It's going to crash in...
As president of the New World Aircraft Corporation, this flight is of paramount importance to me. The fact that members of International Rescue will be on the maiden flight enables us to achieve worldwide publicity. In order to make this possible in the first place, we have given assurances to them that the strictest security arrangements will be enforced. That is why the airfield is cleared of all personnel. The passengers are due to arrive in, 30 minutes.
Verge, I can see them.
At 2 o'clock.
Okay. I've got them, Scott.
Right. Operation Escort. Go.
This is what I call driving in style, m'lady.
Okay, all checks complete. Martin?
Yes, sir.
Lane?
Yes, sir.
Carter?
Yes, sir.
Hogarth?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Return to your posts and await the arrival of the passengers.
Hold it right there. Quickly, we haven't much time.
And now, by the courtesy of the New World Aircraft Corporation, we bring you the drinking off hour.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the New World Aircraft Corporation, I welcome you aboard Skyship One. As you know, this is the maiden flight. It is, of course, a great honor for us to have such distinguished guests. You can be assured that the crew and myself will do everything in our power to make this a trip to remember.
Well, bon voyage.
Bon voyage.
Bon voyage, beloved.
Now, we know the ship is fully automated. Everything is pre-programmed. Height, speed, course. We are all supposed to be trained men. The only way that our cover would be broken would be if anything goes wrong with the ship. Take off now, 30 seconds.
Dinner is served in the bottle room, lady.
Thank you.
Calling Black Phantom. This is White Ghost.
Come in, Black Phantom. Come in, Black Phantom. Have disposed of cargo. Operation Ambush underway.
Calling International Rescue. This is Lady Penelope. Jeff, I want you to send Thunderbird 1 and 2 to a disused airfield 10 miles south of Casablanca. International Fix System 2404, reference E. Ensure that Brains is aboard. This is imperative. Do not acknowledge this transmission. We'll call later with further details.
It's going to be difficult.
That's what we're paid for. Now, I've had this whole place bugged. I want every word she speaks on this trip to be recorded. Whenever possible, I'll talk to her myself and maneuver the conversation in the right direction. Right. Get to work. Okay, Carter. Breakfast is served. Start recording.
Morning, Alan.
Morning, Penny.
Morning, Alan.
Morning,
Tyndon. Breakfast over New York. What an experience.
This is really the way to travel.
Yeah, it's great. Only thing is, as the ship's fully automated, if anything should go wrong with the computer, we could hit one of these skyscrapers, and then we'd really be in trouble.
Then, Alan, it would just be a simple case of calling International Rescue.
And now, gentlemen, it is with pride that I present to you Thunderbird 6. Now, so that I'm able to demonstrate this new machine properly, I have built this radio-controlled model. The situation? Man trapped in top floor of burning skyscraper. Thunderbird 6 drives up to the building. The helium balloon now rises, lifting a plastic hose into the air. When the balloon reaches the correct height, the reel is locked off. And so you see, gentlemen, another international rescue is made possible. Well, Mr. Tracy, what do you think?
Well, it's certainly ingenious, Brains. But it means building a vehicle that gives us only one means of rescue. The end product just doesn't justify the cost. I'm sorry. I'm afraid you'll have to scrap it and start again.
We'll soon be flying over the Grand Canyon at 0 feet. An automated announcement will tell us when it's the right time. Don't worry, you won't miss a thing. There, you can see our exact position. The Grand Canyon. You know, I was once hopelessly lost in a jet plane, and then at last I made contact with the ground. Was I glad to hear that voice. You are directly over the Grand Canyon. Your position, International Fix System 2424, reference E.
Correction, Captain Foster. International Fix System
2404, reference E.
Of course, 2404.
I didn't think I'd ever forget that.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now approaching the Grand Canyon. If you care to take up your positions on the balcony, you'll be in good time to get the most advantageous viewpoint.
I think it's the most beautiful sight I've ever seen.
Come across to the other side of the ship. There's an even better view over there.
Oh!
trust the Beaujolais was to your liking, Parker? And now, how about Isabel?
I've been spending quite a lot of time with the stewards, drinking and all that sort of thing. Well, what worries me, they don't seem to know as much about the ship as they ought to.
Thank you, Parker. I've had my own thoughts on the matter. I'm glad you told me.
Yes. Well, sorry if I disturbed you, m'lady.
You were quite right, Parker. Good night.
Good night, m'lady.
Yes, Penelope?
I've just had some information from Parker, Alan. I'm a little uneasy. Tell me, what do you think of Captain Foster?
I don't go for him, Penelope. He's a little too smooth for my liking.
Tell me, Alan, has he been questioning you about international rescue?
Well, as a matter of fact, he has. Well, not directly, mind you, but the conversation always seems to lead that way.
I think we'll have to go into this situation a little more closely. I don't like the sound of it. The storm seems to be getting worse.
I think you'd better come in here. We need to discuss this right away.
Oh, well, perhaps we are allowing our imaginations to run away with us. After all, everyone's interested in international rescue. It's only natural they should ask questions.
Oh. So you don't think there's anything to worry about, Penelope?
No. After all, they have all been screened. They're carefully selected men.
That was a close one. Put on the edited tape.
Right.
One thing's for sure. You got to play this really cool from now on. Lady Penelope, I underestimated you.
Calling International Rescue. Jeff, I want you to send Thunderbirds 1 and 2. International Fix System 2404. Reference E.
Okay, continue recording.
Doesn't sound as if we'll get much more tonight.
When I was talking to you just now, Alan, I discovered a bugging device in the lamp by my bed.
I wondered why you changed your attitude so abruptly. What's our next move?
For the moment, nothing. We know we're being bugged, but we don't know why. We must just be on the alert.
Okay. I'll mosey around and see what I can find out.
Go ahead, John.
Father, I've just received a message from Lady Penelope. It was sent in scrambled electronic code.
Right, John, let's have it.
It's just coming out of the descrambler now. It reads, ship bugged, reason unknown, am investigating. Imperative, no communication from you. Will contact you when we have a lead. Signed, Penelope.
FAB, John. Keep in touch.
I don't like the sound of it, Dad. We've got to do something about this.
Yeah, but what?
Well, why not radio the police at the next port of call and have the crew interrogated?
No. Whoever it is on that ship that is looking for information is probably an agent for a larger organization. If we're to protect ourselves, we've got to wait for them to show their hand.
Well, stone the crows.
Beautiful, Alan. But it's far too expensive.
Right, we'll take it.
But you won't regret it, sir. It will bring you much happiness.
Oh, Alan, it's been such a lovely day. I just wish it could never end.
The sari suits you very well, Penelope.
It was a very kind thought, Captain. Thank you. Did you get anything interesting today, Tintin?
Yes. Alan bought me this beautiful ring. He paid far too much money for it, but I'm very thrilled with it.
Buying a ring for a young lady is pretty significant to me, Alan. Don't tell me you're going to desert the League of Bachelors.
I'm afraid not, Captain Foster. The life I lead in international rescue is far too dangerous to ask anyone to share it with me. For me, at the moment, marriage is out of the question.
That's right, Captain Foster. We all of us lead dedicated lives in international rescue. And now, if you'll excuse me, I think I'll retire.
But wouldn't you like another drink?
Thank you, Captain, but no.
Oh, so soon?
I'm afraid so. Good night, everyone. So your rooms aren't above, but the lounge, bar, and dining room are. All places where I go. It would seem it's me they want the information from. But what?
If we knew that, we'd know the answer to everything.
Have you found any trace of the receiver? Parker's had no luck.
None. The only place I haven't searched is the gravity compensation room.
Well, the trip comes to an end in 14 days' time. Whatever move they're going to make must be made before we get back to England. So we'll soon know. There's been a terrible air crash. A DX-102 airliner tried to make a forced landing on a disused airfield 10 miles south of Casablanca. Its nose wheel collapsed, and the aircraft blew up, killing all aboard.
At last we've got it. I've got to hand it to you, Carter. That newspaper idea of yours was just great. Now, complete the editing. I want to hear that final message as soon as possible.
Thunderbirds 1 and 2 to a disused airfield 10 miles south of Casablanca. International fix system 2404 reference E. Ensure that Brains is aboard. This is imperative. Do not acknowledge this transmission. We'll call later with further details.
Perfect. Just perfect.
Okay. And what next?
Now watch carefully. Tomorrow, we make our last stop. Switzerland. It certainly is a fantastic car you have, Penelope.
The only one of its kind in the world, Captain Foster.
When those skis appeared out of the bottom, I just couldn't believe my eyes.
Switch it to full boost, Blade.
How are you doing, Tintin?
Fine. Just fine.
Decided what you're going to eat?
I think I'll start with avocado.
Tintin?
Artichoke, please.
Likewise.
Fine. And for me, the speciality of the house.
This is a cute place.
It's certainly imaginative. Let's hope the service is as good.
I guess this is for us.
Gee, what a novel idea.
It must have been fun traveling in trains like this years ago.
Well, let's unload the cargo. As Parker would say, it looks a real good nosh.
Talking of Parker, what's happened to him? Surely he's not still outside.
But of course. The car is heated, you know.
O'clock. We must go. The skyship is programmed for takeoff at midnight.
As a matter of interest, Captain, what would happen if we didn't get back on time?
Your dream holiday would just come to an end. And now, Cinderella, we must go.
Lady.
You debugged the whole place, Parker.
No need, m'lady. It was already done for me. There's not a hidden microphone anywhere, m'lady. They've all been removed.
That can only mean one thing. They've got the information they wanted.
What now? Parker, what have you to report?
Well, m'lady, they've been recording you on a tape machine in the gravity compensation room. I managed to get a look in there. They've been editing the tape, that was obvious. And now they've got the tape machine linked to a radio transmitter.
The jigsaw's nearly completed, but not quite. Parker, issue the guns. They're in the false compartment at the bottom of my blue suitcase. From now on, it's emergency standby.
Black Phantom from White Ghost. Message will be transmitted 1000 hours tomorrow morning.
Gentlemen. The Thunderbird machines will be arriving here at approximately 1100 hours tomorrow morning. The final phase of Operation Ambush has commenced.
Okay. Rewind and stand by.
Okay, ready.
Calling International Rescue. This is Lady Penelope. Jeff, I want you to send Thunderbirds 1 and 2 to a disused airfield 10 miles south of Casablanca. International Fix System 2404, reference E. Ensure that Brains is aboard. This is imperative. Do not acknowledge this transmission. We'll call later with further details.
Thunderbird machines should be arriving in approximately 10 minutes. Stand by. If pilots offer any resistance as they leave the machines, shoot them down.
I've got it. Penelope, I've got it. It's the only possible answer. They've been recording your voice, right?
Right.
They've been editing the tape, right?
Right.
Editing is a form of rearranging.
They've been rearranging your words to make you say something that they wanted you to say, and then they've transmitted it. Now, who's the one person who would act on your instructions?
Why, Jeff Tracy.
Roger, Scott. Understand that you are at disused airfield. Call me as soon as you've landed.
FAB.
Go ahead, Penny.
Jeff, this is an emergency. Have you received a message from me?
Yes, Penelope. The boys are just about to land at the rendezvous you requested.
Jeff, I haven't sent a message. This is a trap.
Now, remember, just one sign of resistance from those pilots, and let them have it.
Thunderbird to base. Oh, thanks, Dad. You gave us the warning just in time. Setting course now to rendezvous with Sky Ship 1.
Okay, I've received a message from Black Phantom to say the Thunderbird machines were landing. By now, they must have taken over the ships, and shortly, they'll be on their way to rendezvous with us. Right, the play acting's over. Round up our international rescue guests. They're unsuspecting, so they won't be armed.
Not so unsuspecting, Captain Foster. Raise your hands, all of you.
Numbers are even now, and we can now shoot you. You know that. Throw your guns down and give yourselves up.
I suggest you throw your guns down. If you don't, you can say goodbye to Tintin.
Contact with Skyship 1.
Right, Scott. At what position do you expect to rendezvous with it?
According to my calculations, at approximately 10,000 feet, about 5 miles east of Dover.
Well, all you can do, Scott, is beat the hell out of those machines and get there as soon as you can.
FAB.
Very smart, Penelope. So you radioed your base.
That's right, Mr. Foster. You should know that you can't outwit international rescue.
I'm not so sure. The game isn't over yet. We have you all as our hostages. When the Thunderbird machines arrive, I've got an idea they're going to do just what we tell them to.
Meanwhile, the gravity compensating machine has come to a standstill. The jet engines on this bus are to give it forward movement only. The ship can't maintain height unless the gravity compensators are working.
I'm well aware of the situation. We're losing height quite slowly. It'll be half an hour yet before there's any real danger. Marty, go up on the top deck and radio down as soon as those Thunderbirds arrive.
Right.
Father, I'm at rendezvous point.
No sign of Skyship 1.
I don't understand it, Scott. It's a big ship. It'd be hard to miss.
Oh, wait.
I can see it. It's about 8,000 feet below me. I don't get it. According to the New World pre-programmed schedule, it should be at 10,000 feet at this point. I'm going down to take a look.
Yeah, baby.
Foster, Thunderbird 1 directly above us.
Okay, Martin.
Right, untie them. I want you all up on the top deck and no false moves.
Dad, there's trouble ahead. Dad, Skyship 1 is losing height. Why, I don't know.
About 1 mile ahead is an early warning system with interceptor towers. The estimated height, 1,200 feet. Below it is a missile site.
The way it looks from here, Skyship 1 is on a collision course. The only thing that can save it is its height. But I've got my doubts.
There's a tower ahead. We're going to hit it.
How far away is it?
I don't know. About a quarter of a mile.
I'm coming up.
Dad, there's going to be a collision. You'd better alert all emergency services down on the ground. It's a missile base about 5 miles east of Dover.
Yeah, baby.
Well, the ship's swaying on top of one of the towers. If that tower gives way or the ship loses its balance, it's going to drop like a stone right onto that missile site below.
Come on, quickly! Up on the top deck and move!
We've crashed, Foster. Don't you understand? Throw your gun away. We're all in this together now.
I said move!
Scott, I've been listening to your transmission. I've sighted Skyship. I'm coming in straight over the top.
We'll lower escape unit. Brains is already in there.
FAB.
Attention. Attention. All personnel in Sector D to vacate site immediately. Proceed with all movable equipment to rendezvous G. This is an emergency. Repeat. This is an emergency.
The top of the tower is crumbling. I'm going to attach a line to the front of the ship to see if I can hold it steady.
FAB.
What the heck are they doing?
From Thunderbird 2, 1 mile from you.
Have landed on a grassy stretch down below.
Well done, Virg.
Okay, brains. Over to you.
Scott and Virgil, I'm gonna circle the ship and then attempt a landing.
Okay, brains.
Right, Scott. I'm in position. Brains is on his way up.
I'm gonna fix a line to this end.
Okay, Virg.
Attaching line.
Don't tell me they're gonna try a rescue with that thing. They must have got it from a museum.
You're dead right, Mr. Foster. But I'll tell you something. It's a brilliant idea. I think it's the only chance we've got.
Lane, get over on the other side of the deck. Get ready to welcome our guest.
Right.
As soon as you touch down, I'll open up with my jets. The slipstream should slow you down.
Right. Let's try it.
FAB. Penelope and Ellen, in a few moments,
I'm going to open up my jet engines. Now hold tight to that rail. Alan, raise your hand if you've understood me.
Okay, folks. Hold tight!
Well done, Brains.
Okay. Tintin, you're first. Jump aboard.
Oh, no, you don't. Get out of that cockpit and move.
Scott, one of the stewards has got brains at gunpoint.
What are they going to do, Virg?
Looks as if Penelope's boarding the aircraft.
And the captain's getting into the rear cockpit.
Okay, turn this crate around.
Oh, what's happened to brains? Everyone's moving towards the Tiger. There's no doubt about it. The crew are in control of the situation.
Come on! Hurry it up! Get back fast! This thing's gonna collapse any moment! What makes you think I'm coming back? The double-crosser! We've gotta stop him!
Oh!
Thunderbird to base. Father, we're not going to be able to hold her much longer. How's the evacuation of the rocket site progressing?
Nearly complete, but they want about another 5 minutes. Do everything you can, Scott, to prevent that ship falling.
Throttle back! We're down!
And where's the throttle?
Down on the left-hand side! Penny, that's the wrong way!
Thunderbird 1?
Loud and clear.
Scott, I've just received the okay from the missile base. Evacuation has been completed. You can let her go.
Right. Did you hear that, Virgil?
I heard.
Okay.
Release cables on 5-second countdown.
FAB.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Cockpit now.
our engine gone, Penny. Hold tight. Hold tight, Tintin! I'm putting you down!
Okay, Alan.
Hold tight, Brains! Emergency landing!
Good luck, Alan!
Say, Alan, that was a fantastic landing.
Well, if it hadn't been for Parker, we could have said we'd got away with it. Are you sure there was no chance of him surviving when Skyship 1 crashed?
Not a chance, Alan.
I suppose it must be shock, but a few moments ago, I'm sure I heard a distant voice calling, "Milady."
That's funny. I thought I heard it, too. And now, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you all my new vehicle, Thunderbird 6.
Thunderbird 6? I don't get it.
Oh, I know what you're going to say, Mr. Tracy, that you haven't approved the plans, that how could it have been built anyway, etc., etc., etc. But nevertheless, I present to you Thunderbird 6. Built, tested, and approved. This is Thunderbird Control. Launch Thunderbird 6.
Brains. Well, I'll be a...
Look at that.
Brains, you old son of a gun. I'll buy it. I agree it's a good design. It has been built, and it sure has been tested.